To help provide context on the events that have transpired in that Dolphins locker room, I'm joined now by ESPN columnist Jason Whitlock. Thanks for your time tonight, Jason.
Thank you, Keith.
Let me start with this breaking news. Daily vulgar comments, malicious physical attack, verbal sexual threat against his sister. When Chris Carter said the other day we only had heard the tip of the iceberg, I guess he was right.
Yeah, I think that what is going on in the Dolphins locker room and quite possibly in other locker rooms is a culture and an environment that's gotten out of hand. Rookie hazing has been a part of all sports for a long time, but I just think the culture has been corrupted, and with Richie Incognito being a part of the leadership council of the Miami Dolphins, which is laughable to put this guy out there as a role model and put him out there as a leader. Things in Miami clearly have just gone way too far.
Yeah, and they're going to continue to go too far, at least in terms of our knowledge of them. Even as we were on the air tonight, the word came that he was investigated last year, Incognito was, for harassing, and that's probably a polite term, a woman volunteer at a Dolphins team event. No charge, just investigated. So it's just going to continue. But to that bigger picture rather than the details, I want to read an excerpt from the piece you published at ESPN.com today. Welcome to Incarceration Nation, where the mindset of the Miami Dolphins locker room mirrors the mentality of a maximum security prison yard, and where a wide swath of America believes the nonviolent intellectual needs to adopt the tactics of the barbarian. I mean, is that what we're seeing? We're seeing like sort of like Shawshank Redemption playing out here? I mean, what is the Incarceration Nation mindset?
Well, I think that mass incarceration, a political policy strategy, adopted in the late 60s, early 70s, America's drug war, has created some outgrowths and some ramifications that I don't think a lot of people in America fully understand. We've created a perverted culture that mirrors the culture that's necessary to survive in prison. I think when you look at the Dolphin players circling the wagons, defending Richie Incognito, justifying his use of the N-word and considering him an honorary black man. I think this is a guy who is a prison yard bully, who has the respect of that locker room, and they don't respect a Jonathan Martin. And I think this is kind of pervasive throughout our culture that somehow the educated black man, the articulate black man, the nonviolent black man is somehow not authentically black, while someone like Richie Incognito, an idiot, a goon, someone who tosses around the N-word indiscriminately, he somehow has the respect of his black teammates. It's a culture that's out of hand. It's a young generation of people that really don't understand African-American history here in this country, and they just haven't been raised or taught well. I think it's a reflection of mass incarceration and unfettered illegitimacy of too many young black kids in America that just haven't grown up in the proper environment and structure to understand just who we are and how to carry yourself respectfully and how to demand respect from other people.
Which would presumably feed into something. We had an expert on the show last night, a doctor from UMass Amherst, who's an expert on bullying and the more formal term workplace discrimination and harassment, who said that the reason that you see the bullies in these contexts supported by so many people is essentially Stockholm syndrome. That they are the favorite, that the people who are supporting the Richie Incognitos and the other people who have those roles, perhaps on other NFL teams, are there not so much out of fear, but because they believe this is the structure now, and this they are getting along and succeeding within it.
Absolutely. Listen, when the Dolphins allowed someone with Richie Incognito's background to be a part of their leadership council, when it apparently Jeff Ireland, Joe Philbin instructed this guy to toughen up Jonathan Martin. I think there's just been this great misunderstanding of Jonathan Martin. Young kid, comes from two highly educated parents, studied at one of our great universities, Stanford University. He wasn't properly prepared for the NFL, and the Dolphins weren't properly prepared on how to handle him, and so they drop him into this environment. And we sit around and question, well, why did he act like he liked Richie Incognito? Why didn't he take a firm stance against Richie Incognito? the organization has held him up as the role model for the entire franchise. A young kid comes in and thinks, I have to get along with him. I have to adapt his mindset to survive in the National Football League. And eventually this kid, because he was properly raised and sane, he eventually snapped and said, I don't want to be a part of this, right. And he walked away from the Dolphins.
All right, so what does the NFL do about this? Because you can't just walk away from this culture. It can't just be in Miami. I've been saying since the parameters of this thing began to break earlier in this week that what they did to New Orleans with Bounty Gate almost demands that the NFL take some sort of major punitive action against the Miami franchise, even if they're not the worst offenders, even if they're not the first offenders. What do you think is going to happen?
I do think an example needs to be set. I think that Roger Goodell needs to start with Richie Incognito. His rap sheet in the NFL, I think, dictates that. As it relates to Jeff Ireland and Joe Philbin, I really think that's the Miami Dolphins ownership's responsibility to take action against those guys. Now, if Jeff Ireland did tell the agent that Jonathan Martin needs to punch Richie Incognito and deal with him physically, then perhaps the commissioner, if they can prove that, the commissioner needs to get involved. But I think Stephen Ross, the owner of the Miami Dolphins, these are his two paid leaders of this franchise. And everything I've heard from Miami Dolphins players, they're in desperate need of some adult leadership that they're not getting from Jeff Ireland or Joe Philbin.
They need it from somebody. Jason Whitlock, the column about Incarceration Nation, worth your time, as always, is talking to Jason Whitlock about almost anything we could be talking about. Thank you again, Jason.
Thank you, Keith.